Wait, what? How short a week is it, Mr. Renfrow? What do you mean?
Well, this is going to transition us right into reminders because we only have school today and tomorrow. You guys are off Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday in celebration of Thanksgiving. So I hope that you guys have the best time with your families, eat a whole bunch of delicious food. I know I am. What about you?
Oh, for sure. We like pie and mashed potatoes at our house.
I like it all.
Oh, yeah. Turkey, all that good stuff.
Yep. I'll eat all of it. All right, guys. So some more reminders. When you come back next week after Thanksgiving break, we will start our next round of NWEA. As you guys know, we took it at the beginning of the year to find out your levels, and now we're going to take it again here in the winter, and we'll take it one more time at the end of the year. It's really important that you guys give your best effort so we can see how much you've grown and we can put you in the correct group for interventions. So a couple things with NWEA. The first one are the trophies. If you want to get the trophy for your classroom, it's who has the most growth, all right? So give it your best effort, show everything you learn, and hopefully you can steal a trophy from another teacher. So that's always fun. It's always hard to hold on to them, guys, when you have at the beginning of the year. And then the second thing, we have posters for each and every one of you who has grown since the beginning of the year. And what's really cool, your name will be written big on this poster. You get to decorate it. You can either do it at school. You can take it home. Your parents can write you an awesome note on it. And then we're going to make a huge collage in the hallways of all of these together. Last year, we had to go on like a hallway and a half because they filled it up so much.
Ooh, I can't wait to see this.
We're the smartest kids here, Caze. So make sure you guys, like I said, give your best effort. Show how much you've learned so we can make sure we help you the best way we can for the rest of the year and we can celebrate all of your growth.
And if you get stuck on one, it's okay. I mean, just give it your best thinking and keep going because you might know the next one. So don't get frustrated if there's a one you don't know or two or three you don't know. It's okay. That's part of it.
Yeah. And another thing this week, because it's a short week and we have stuff coming up, there's actually no after school this week.
That's right.
So you will not go to the gym or the cafeteria unless you're daycare. You will go home the way you normally do. So make sure you have transportation organized and you guys head directly home after school.
Good catch.
All right, so you have a reminder for everyone, right? What's been on your brain and heart?
A little reminder. We know our Caze students have such amazing heart. We see it all the time. But we are seeing a few more things in kindergarten, first, second, third, fourth, and fifth, all our school, where kids are putting their hands on one another. And it might start out as play, but you know my silly line that I say to you, some of you know this, I say, even if it's play, it's not okay.
Oh, because, I'm gonna have to use that.
Because, you know, somebody might be having a bad day, and me even touching them could make them feel frustrated or angry or just uncomfortable. So leave that space. Please keep hands to self, even if you're playing, not okay. And keep our school safe. Keep our students safe. We want everyone to be calm and have great days here at Caze.
Handshake, hugs, high fives with permission, as well as like tagging, playing a game of tag. That's about all we allow. Anything else, I don't care if you're playing. We don't do that here. We have heart. We're going to be safe and we're going to be kind to each other. So we actually have some people who are going to explain conflict resolution if you are really upset with someone. So stay tuned and heart monitors.
All right, guys, I'm here with some of my fifth grade heart monitors, and they're going to teach us a little bit about conflict resolution today. Conflict is when you have an issue with someone, and resolution is how you fix it. So, Annelle, what is the first thing you need to do when you have a conflict?
To calm down.
I agree. Great job. Why is it important to calm down, though?
To make good choices.
Excellent. I agree. Now, what are some things you can do to calm down?
Walk away, ask for help, virtually feeling, and take a deep breath.
Those are great. Thank you so much for sharing. All right, now I have Dione who's going to tell us about step two. What is step two, Dione, after you calm down?
To make sure if it's a big problem or a small problem.
I agree. Why is it important to know if it's a big problem or a small problem?
To solve it.
Right, helps you know how to solve it. Dione, what is a big problem?
A big problem is if you're injured or if somebody hits you.
Yeah, so those would be emergencies, right?
Yes.
How do you know if it's a small problem?
Anything else.
Okay, so what about if someone called your mama a bad name?
You just, that's a small problem. You can just, like, tell a teacher or something.
Hey, great. Thank you so much, Fiona. All right, now I'm here with Samaria. We learned that we need to calm down first, then we need to decide if it is a big problem or a small problem. Now, if it's a big problem, Samaria, what should we do?
You should tell an adult.
I agree. If it's a small problem, what should we do?
You should solve it.
Right. Now, if it's a small problem, what are some things you could do that would turn it into a big problem that we should not do?
If you are yelling at each other or fighting or kicking.
Yeah, that makes it worse, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Great. So what are some things you can do to solve a small problem?
You could talk it out, walk away, ignore, or tell a teacher.
Wonderful. Thank you guys for your advice. Let's say goodbye to everyone.
Goodbye.
Okay, we're back. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Heart Monitors. That was a really good message. I hope you guys really listen to them because they are giving you great advice that will last you your whole life. Not just with your friends, but in your relationships in the future, in your jobs in the future. So it's really important to know how to take a second, calm down, think about the problem, and then solve it instead of turning it into a bigger problem. So good job, Heart Monitors. Now we're ready to move on to celebrations, which, you know, I always love.
We've had so many good ones this
year. Yeah. Our basketball teams. Guys, I am so proud of you. It's been so much fun to watch you. You guys are working hard. You're showing good sportsmanship. Mm-hmm. So keep up the great work.
It is so fun to watch mm-hmm. you. See all your running, jumping, shooting, good sportsmanship. It's amazing. Fun, fun, fun. Mm-hmm. And right along that with that, Miss Walker, we just want to have a big shout out for Miss Walker because she's been such a great leader with our cheerleaders.
Yes.
And the cheerleader shirts that she stayed up, I don't even know how late, making. They are so cool. Cheerleaders look amazing. Thanks, Miss Walker. Thanks, cheerleaders, yes. for leading us when we get to
really, really days. Appreciate you. Next, I'd like to celebrate our new secretary, Miss Christy. You guys might have seen her in the office. Miss Julie is actually in another office because she took a new job working with some students and their families. So we got to hire a new secretary. So Miss Christy is now with us. And we just think she's doing amazing. So make sure when you see her, say, hi, Miss Christy, or good morning, Miss Christy, or I'm happy you're here, Miss Christy. And let's welcome her to Caze the right way.
And so she told me the other day, I don't even know if you know this, Miss Renfrow, she told me the other day that how fun it is for her, how kind students are to her, and they do that. And just, it made her feel so warm and welcome at Caze. So thank you, Caze mm-hmm. Cougars, for helping us out.
I'm so happy to hear that.
Me too.
Don't you have another celebration?
Oh, another celebration. Oh, yes. This was so amazing. So this past week, it was Miss Scott's birthday, our STEM teacher.
Yeah.
And I got to watch Miss Willenbrink's whole class. They made her the most amazing birthday cards and aww. Surprised her and came up. It was the neatest thing. I know Miss Scott loved it. Mm-hmm. And I love to see the joy that all Miss Willenbrink students had when they shared their birthday wishes with her. It was so cool. Love it. Way to go, Miss Willenbrink's
class.
Great
job, guys. Another group of students I would like to shout out are our heart monitors. We put them on committees. They started doing some great things like recycling, helping with the morning meetings, helping with the fire drill, or not the fire drill, the tornado drill we had last week. So good job, guys. Keep up your leadership. All right, let's hear what shout out you guys have for us.
I want to give a shout out to Emmett in Miss Olson's class for being nice to me, and he's always my friend. And I want to give a shout out to Hendrix and Miss Hoopers because he always helps me. And I want to give a shout out to Tiffany and Mrs. Mod Eyes.
I want to give a shout out to Miss Granderson for being the nice teacher ever. And I want to give a shout out to Kyrie H. And I want to give a shout out to Vincent.
I want to give a shout out to all of these students in Miss Cooper's class. They finished their independent work during reading groups, and so then they could work on stations. I'm so proud of them. Keep up the great work.
I want to give a shout out to Miss Rufa to being the best principal, and I want to give a shout out to my whole class.
I want to give a shout out to Ms. Willenbrink for being the best teacher and always trying to show us things, math, and she's just the best teacher in the whole entire world.
I want to give a shout out to Carrie H for being the bestest friend and Marjan for being a bestest person ever.
I want to give a shout out to Miss Ball for being one of the best teachers I ever had.
I want to give a shout out to Marjan for helping me I want to also give a shout out to Josiah for helping me last year. I want to give a shout out to Everett for helping me in skills.
I'd like to give a shout out to Zyla Currington for her cheer competition. She went to St. Louis last weekend and they won first place and qualified for nationals. Way to go.
Hi, this is Miss Wilson, and I want to give a shout out to Miss Tinberger's class and Miss Olson's second grade class for working so hard together and collaborating to learn about learning challenges and helping our third graders who are helping those second graders learn how to read.
Fussing and following the election.
All right, thanks for those shout outs, guys. Now, we have a connecting activity that you guys have loved in the past. I'm not looking forward to doing it again. You know what we're doing?
I'm a little nervous. I'm just a little nervous. Okay, I'm ready.
So, we have 5 different flavors of baby food here. So we're gonna have a baby food Thanksgiving meal. Instead of like regular turkey and sweet potatoes and pumpkin pie and banana pudding, we're gonna eat the baby food version.
Okay, all right.
So
we can do this, we can do hard things.
We have 2 tasks while we do this. Number 1, don't throw up. Keep it in your mouth. Number 2, we have to guess what we're eating based off of the flavor.
Okay. All right, I'll go first. Since you've done this before, you
Well, let's do it together. Let's do it together. We'll both grab our spoons.
Okay. And we don't know what it is, so we're keeping it.
All right. Well, I'm going to do a cheers.
Sure.
Cheers.
Bink. Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Oh.
Ew.
Oh, my.
I can't take a bigger bite.
Nope. Okay.
Sorry. What do you think it is?
My guess is carrots, but I really don't know. Mm-hmm. And the answer is?
I was going to say carrots or sweet potatoes because it's orange and it tastes gross.
The answer is?
Carrots, sweet potatoes, and peas.
Oh, all together. Oh, okay. Clean the spoon and start again.
Yeah, I'm going to get a little less on my spoon.
It's funny because, I mean, I like those foods, Miss Renfrow, but I don't know if I like them as baby food. Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay.
Okay.
All right. Here we go.
Ready?
Okay.
Just a little bitty dab. 1, 2, 3. Oh.
Ooh.
That one's a little meaty.
Oh, wow. That's not good.
Okay. It's meat. Don't you taste meat in there?
Like gravy? Turkey?
Turkey, chicken, pork, beef, one of those. Let's see.
Okay.
Turkey.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Ooh.
Wow.
Well, I need a drink.
Okay.
I'm going to take a deep breath.
Yeah, me too.
Mm-hmm.
This is okay. Rough. Next.
Okay. Oh, I'm not lounge again. I can't do much more than this.
Okay.
All right. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, that wasn't that bad.
Oh, it actually wasn't. It was sweet.
It was. Is it pumpkin?
It's orange.
I could actually finish my spoon that time.
I'm going to go with pumpkin.
Okay. Yeah. Maybe?
Oh, sweet potatoes.
Oh, that was not bad.
I don't want to eat a whole thing, but
no,
it wasn't bad.
It was not as bad as the rest.
All right. Okay.
Oh, this one's kind of like a radioactive color.
Mm. Is it mustard?
It looks like straight mustard.
I like mustard.
But I love mustard.
I want it out of the baby. All right,
let's take a sniff real quick.
Ooh,
this is savory. Like this. 1, 2, 3, go.
Ooh, my. Oh, whoa.
That's gross.
Yeah?
Ew. That tastes kind of meaty, too.
I was going to say, like, peas, but it's not the right color for peas.
I think it's meat.
Like chicken or something?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Chicken. Chicken noodle.
Oh. Oh, wow. Ugh. That's not tasting like the chicken noodle that I know and love. That's not it.
Okay. All right.
Last one.
Save the best for last, hopefully.
All right, here we go.
Just luck.
Okay. It's a kind of a plain color. Mm-hmm. See it?
All right. Well, I know what this is based off of what it smells like.
It smells better.
Yeah.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
I mean,
ooh, this is good.
It's pretty good.
I could eat this.
I don't want to, but it's not bad compared to the rest.
I
kind
of want to.
Oh!
That's really good.
Okay, what is it?
What do you think it is?
I mean, it's sweet. It, maybe like a fruit, like a banana or something like that?
I think it's a banana. Banana!
Oh, wow.
Look at us go. So, we wanted to enjoy Thanksgiving together, but there's also another reason why we're eating all this baby food, and most of you already know, but it's because I have a baby in my belly. I'm pregnant. Isn't that crazy?
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. And so a lot of you have been asking, so are you going to be gone? Are you going to be gone? I should only really be gone the last week of school, and then I won't be at summer school this year, but I should be here up until then, and I should be back when school starts next year. And you guys are all so excited about whether I'm having a boy or a girl. So you will actually find out next week what I'm going to do on Tuesday, November 28th. At each recess, I'm going to go out and do a gender reveal. So I'm inviting you to wear a blue shirt if you think it's a boy, or a pink shirt if you think it's a girl that day. And I'll take a picture of you guys standing in groups in the playground, and then I'll do the gender reveal, and we can see if you were right or wrong. Just as a reminder with this, since I'm pregnant, I know some of you guys love to give me the best hugs where you jump up in my arms, but I really am not supposed to lift anything heavy, so please make sure that you just give me nice, gentle hugs, and we'll save the jumping up into my arms until next year.
That sounds like a good thing. It's such fun news. You know, Miss Renfrow always talks about how we are Kay's family, so it's super fun to celebrate with her. I know you guys are celebrating with her, too, as part of our family.
You guys have been the sweetest. Some of you guys have been even telling the baby good morning when you come in this morning. It is so sweet. Like, they'll say, tell me hi, and then hug me, look at my belly, and say, good morning, baby. It's so cute. So, I love it. Thank you guys for being so encouraging and happy for me and my family. And I know I am personally happy that we only have 2 days this week.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be a good week, and we are thankful for all of you. Thankful for our cougars, our families, and all the staff. Thank you, thank you. We're super thankful for all of you guys.
Yes, thank you guys. Have a great week.
Happy Thanksgiving.